Happy Kids TV. The Holy Tales.
Hello, kids. We all know why we have gathered here today, don't we?
Of course. We are all here to listen to a new story about one more disciple of Jesus among the 12.
Absolutely. So, today I'm going to tell you the story of James, the elder.
The elder? That was his name?
Well, no, but that's what he was mostly known as.
But why?
Let us listen to the story, and we shall find out the reason soon. One of Jesus' 12 disciples was James the Elder. James was the son of a man called Zebedee, and he was also the brother of John, one of Jesus' disciples. John and James were very close to one another as brothers, and they were almost inseparable. James was a fisherman, and he lived with his family in Bethsaida, Capernaum, and then in Jerusalem. James went all around Jerusalem and Judea, preaching Jesus' teachings, where he was beheaded by King Herod in AD 44. However, the New Testament of the Bible tells us very little about the life of James, apart from when it mentions about his brother John. James was always known for being courageous and forgiving. He was never jealous of anyone or any of the disciples of Jesus. He had completely surrendered his faith and life to Jesus as a follower and as a disciple. However, most of his life he lived in the shadow of his brother John. Like all the other disciples, he too had his own apostolic sign, which was three shells, representing him as a pilgrim off the sea.
Oh, he was the elder brother of John, and that is why he was known as James the Elder.
Yes, that is right. Hope you children have enjoyed the story.
Of course we have. We always do.
To watch more videos, please subscribe.
The Holy Tales.
And today, I am going to tell you the story of Judas.
Judas? The traitor? I would like to know more about him.
Come on, let's begin with the story. Judas Iscariot was the son of a man called Simon, and he lived in Kirioth of Judah. In spite of being a disciple, he was the traitor, because of whom Jesus was put to the cross. He betrayed Jesus and broke his trust for 30 pieces of silver. However, the guilt of betrayal eventually led him to kill himself. Judas was one of the closest disciples of Jesus, and he was given the responsibility of being the treasurer. Unlike the other disciples, who were Galileans, Judas was a Judean, as he came from Judea near Jericho. Judas was also one of the outspoken members who were quite prominent among all the 12 disciples. Judas loved his nation with all his heart and always wanted to do something big. So he joined Jesus' band to fulfill his own nationalistic dreams and wishes. Judas would often take undue advantage of being the treasurer and take money from the common fund for his own personal use. Jesus knew and understood all of this, but he never judged him for that. Judas betraying Jesus for 30 pieces of silver is of great mystery to people even now. It is difficult for people to see someone so close to Jesus who was a witness to so many miracles and teachings of his master, could ever betray him into the hands of his enemies. But it is not Judas's betrayal that put Jesus on the cross. It was our sins. Later, Matthias replaced Judas among the 12 disciples, and he went to places like the shores of the Caspian Sea and Cappadocia to spread the gospel.
So that was the story of Judas the traitor. I see.
So the lesson for today is, we should not take undue advantage of the power given to us. And also,
not be greedy, like Judas.
Well done, Freckles. So it is important that you all be good children.
Yes, Holy, we will. Bye-bye. We'll be back soon.
Bye, children. Keep watching.
To watch more videos, please subscribe.
The Holy Tales.
Today I'll tell you the story of Peter.
Peter? The one who denied Jesus?
Yes. Come on. Let's hear his story. Simon Peter was the son of Jonas, the fisherman. He lived in Bethsaida and Capernaum and grew up to become a fisherman just like his father. He is known for doing massive missionary work and for going as far as Babylon to spread Jesus' words to the people. In the latter years of his life, he also wrote down 2 epistles of the New Testament. In all apostolic lists all over the world, Peter's name is mentioned first. However, he had many different names in other languages also. Peter's Greek name was Simon, and his Hebrew name was Cephas, which both meant rock. Peter lived in Capernaum with his wife, and every time Jesus went there, he would make Peter's home his headquarters. Peter was a Galilean too, like almost all the other disciples of Jesus. Among the 12 disciples, Peter was the leader. He was known to be the spokesman for all the 12 apostles. Peter always asked the most difficult and challenging questions to Jesus. It was Peter who asked how often one must forgive. He also wanted to know about the rewards of following Jesus. He was the one who confessed and declared that Jesus was the Son of the living God. Yet, it was he who denied Jesus before a maiden. Peter had many faults, but his saving grace was his loving heart. When it was decided that Peter was to be martyred on a cross, he requested to be crucified with his head downward, as he believed he was not worthy of dying the same way as his Lord had died. And hence, his apostolic symbol is a cross upside down with crossed keys. So, did you enjoy the story?
Yes, we did.
It was a nice story indeed.
Great. Now off you go, children. It's nap time.
All right, Holy. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
To watch more videos, please subscribe.
Plants and trees. On the 4th day, God created the sun to shine in the day, the moon and stars to come out at night. One day, Moses went to Mount Horeb with his sheep. There, God appeared to him as a flame of fire in a bush. Since there was no room anywhere else, they decided to spend the night in a stable. Here, Mary had her baby, Jesus. She wrapped him in a blanket and put him to sleep.
He's got the Holy